This is the slide which you need to understand if you want to learn Spark, right? And this slide is very important also if you really want to learn Spark. Why it is important? So somewhere in 2004, Hadoop came. That's what the year there. And with Hadoop, you got something called MapReduce. You know what is MapReduce. I don't have to teach, right? Till 2015, I can say, you can say 2007 till 2015, what happened was that one of the problems with Hadoop was that you have MapReduce. Fine, no problem. But what MapReduce does is batch processing. It is slow and it does batch processing. So people wanted to try different type of workloads in Hadoop. So some of them wanted to write SQL queries on top of Hadoop. That is where you got Hive. Then we got Impala. Then we got Presto. Now here you have Drill and many tools. So around 10 plus different SQL tools are there which can explore the data in Hadoop. And some other people wanted machine learning to be done on top of Hadoop. So if you, in the earlier versions before Spark, when people want to do machine learning, they use something called Mahout. Apache Mahout. Here you can see Mahout somewhere here. This is your machine learning library. But what is the problem? Machine learning is what? It is about iteration. What do you mean by iteration? Like you are taking the same data and iterating over and over again, right? One of the things which MapReduce cannot do is iteration. Because if you write a MapReduce program, the mapper will run, reducer will run, it will push the data to hard disk. Again, the second iteration, again you have to read it. So when Mahout was doing machine learning, the problem was that it was very, very slow because internally it uses MapReduce on top of Hadoop. So Mahout came, but this became your machine learning tool, okay? And so interactive we covered. For graph processing, we got GraphLang, Pregel. So these are the tools which you use for graph processing on Hadoop, traditional Hadoop, no Spark or nothing. Then people wanted to do a streaming data analysis, real-time data. That is where you got Storm, right? So you see the problem, right? Over the period of 8 to 10 years, people started developing different tools to handle different workload. So if today I go to a Hadoop system, and if I'm very new to Hadoop, and if I ask somebody what tool I should learn, then he will be confused because all these things you have to learn, Pig, Hive, Mahout, everything to start working with Hadoop. Another problem is if let's say one fine day you start learning Storm. Storm is real-time processing. You have to first learn Storm's API, Storm's language. Then you have to install it on top of Hadoop. You should learn the integration. Then only it starts working. So learning all these different tools actually became a problem. Okay. And what happened in 2014 when Spark came, the biggest USP of Spark is that it is a unified processing engine. What these 50 plus tools on Hadoop are doing, Spark alone can do. That is the real advantage of Spark. Now, many people confuse here because if you go to anybody and ask like why somebody should learn Spark, they will say because it is faster. Now, speed is a byproduct of Spark. It is faster, I know, but the real reason why people are migrating to Spark is that all these tools, whatever they are doing, Spark alone can do. So you don't have to learn like hundreds of tools. You learn one tool, one language, and you can do everything. But you need to have some basic idea about what you're going to do. For example, if you want to do machine learning, Spark has something called MLlib, machine learning library. That will allow you to do machine learning. But you should know what is machine learning, then only you can do. Otherwise, you cannot explore it. But I don't have to install 10 tools or 20 tools. Spark alone can do it. So the primary reason why people are going for Spark is this general unified engine. In my experience, the second reason is speed. Obviously, it is faster. I will tell you why it is faster, how it is faster and all. The third reason is ease of programming. Like, you know Python now. So you can get started with Python in Spark. The language is Python. And if you want to write SQL queries or streaming or machine learning for everything, you can use Python in Spark. That is not the case in the traditional world. Pig uses a different language. Storm uses a different language. So every tool here actually uses a different language. Even for graph processing, in Spark, you can use Python, normal Python. So ease of programming is another thing, because I have struggled a lot, because I have worked a couple of these tools. I have worked as part of the project, and then the major problem is that you will take some 3-4 months to learn the tool first. Then when you come back, that tool will be obsolete. They'll say, go and learn some other tool. So with Spark, that gap is gone. So that is why every company want to migrate to Spark. And it is easy to write, faster also. So I say that MapReduce is almost obsolete. That is a use case. And also another problem is that, yes, these tools are going to get obsolete, but tomorrow they will not be obsolete. So what happens is that these tools are already in production in many companies, and they cannot one fine day come and say, we'll remove everything. But yes, going over, already MapReduce is gone, I told you, right? MapReduce is obsolete. Pig is gone. There is a tool called Apache Pig. Nobody is using Pig. I was teaching a lot of folks on Pig, but now Pig is gone. So some of them are almost extinct. Storm is gone. Very interesting use case, because Storm was once like the king of the industry in streaming data processing. The problem is that Storm is actually 100% real time. So, but Spark Streaming is batch, micro batch. That was the only competition. Now Flink came, Apache Flink. Flink is again same thing, streaming, but real time. Not like micro batching. So what people are doing, most of the use cases you can handle with Spark Streaming. It's very rare you want micro level event processing. There they will have a Flink installed and that will handle it. So Storm is totally gone. So Flink is a kind of like a competition to Spark Streaming, because it is real time. But I am seeing that most of the companies are doing most of their case studies using Spark Streaming only, because you get only one thing they have to make, like real 100% real time. It is near real time now. If it is 100% real time, then in Spark, so there is something called streaming. We will come to that. Streaming data means you want to process real time data. Say I gave you an example, right? So let's say credit card fraud detection. I swipe my credit card, and that has to be immediately captured by some system, and it has to say whether it is fraud or not. This is real time, right? Now to implement this, one solution I have is Spark Streaming. In Spark, I can do it, okay? But Spark does something called micro batching, meaning it is not able to capture a single swipe as it is. It will collect 1 second worth data. So I cannot go below 1 second. 1 second worth data. But if I'm using something like Storm, it can even pick one swipe in that microsecond and say there is a swipe. But I'm saying that is not so important. Like 1 second worth delay you can suffer at least. Still you can manage with Spark most of the cases. But yes, Spark supports streaming. So in this and this Pregel, Giraffe, these guys are gone. So graph processing is totally gone. We have Spark for that. Most of the Mahout is gone, I told you, right? Taze is there. Soon will be gone. Almost soon will be gone, because Taze is middle of MapReduce and Spark. What Taze does, it makes your MapReduce faster. That is what Taze does basically. So Spark makes it more faster. So it is in the middle. So almost it will be gone in a couple of years. Hortonworks is the company who is promoting Taze. So probably they will keep it because they want market share, right? That is the reason.